Studio AKA, animation studio, mostly commercials. You can see, if this works, you can see all of our stuff at Studio AKA. Anything that we're prepared to show you is up there. If it's not, it's in the drawer of shame and I've got the key. There's 25 of us in the studio, four directors. The chap there with the hat on is a young guy who's too shy to have his photograph on the site at the moment, but he's a young up-and-coming director. We also look after these guys here, Studio Soy, a young German studio who used to be students of mine and are now probably going to take us over one day. My background, I should say also, I did an hour's worth of talk in semi-permanent on at the weekend, and it was a 2 hours worth of talk squeezed into an hour. So now I've got to do an hour squeezed into about half an hour. So by the time I've finished here, I'll be able to do the whole thing in about 5 minutes. So I consider myself quite an eclectic designer, director, animator. I'm probably at the fringes of what most people would call design, but it's a form of design. We tend to think about what we do with one very simple mantra, which is not to impose our style upon a project, but to look at the project and say, you know, what's the best approach? What's the best solution for that particular set of problems? My background, goodness me, I did quite a lot more in depth on this at the weekend about the journey I've had since being a student. What you're looking at there is my a piece from my student film. It's fantastic when I look at it now. It's everything a young sort of, you know, early 20s student animator should be doing. It's Bertolt Brecht. It's too long. It's very, very grim. I still love it, but it comes from the time when I would have very seriously worn a beret, put clay on my trousers because it gave me a better chance with the ladies. And I graduated out of that into a kind of surreal but strangely appealing kind of characters. These characters here are from a film I made when I was studying at the Royal College of Art. This was my first attempt at a children's film. It made no sense whatsoever, and I didn't then touch children's animation in any shape or form until last year. So it shows you how successful that was. I'm probably, up until last year, I'm most known as a director for a film called Our Pook Is Here, which is a six-minute film based upon the texts of William Burroughs. I made it in Stuttgart, in Germany, for lots of reasons I won't go into right now, because that would take another hour. But this, I suppose, marks the point where I was working in stop frame animation, again with quite sort of dark, serious sensibilities. I'm going to play you a couple of clips. It's a much longer film, but I'll play you a couple of clips quickly. Try saying that quickly. And you'll get a flavour for what I was doing. So I guess it was about 24, 25 when this was happening.
Hiroshima. 1945, August 6, 16 minutes past 8 a.m. Who really gave that order?
Answer, control. The ugly American, the instrument of control.
Question, if control's control is absolute, why does control need to control?
Answer, control needs time.
Question, is control controlled by its need to control?
Answer, yes.
So I think the beret had come off at that point, mostly because it precipitated my baldness, but has been at great odds against everything I've done since, I guess. I, like you, I'm looking up here now, looking at a smattering of the bits and pieces that I've done in the sort of, in the time in between. I co-founded Studio AKA out of the ashes of another studio. I have two partners, and my main role in the studio has been creative director. So probably the biggest step I took in the past couple of, how do I get rid of that? Thank you. The biggest step I took in the last 10 years was actually a big step backwards, behind a lot of other people. I've been responsible for the development and promotion of the directors in the studio itself. So I've directed less frequently, but I hope with more consideration. And I'm sort of emerging from that point at the moment. So from having been somebody who was very, very driven and prolific at a very young age, I'm at that stage now, after having had a period of kind of managing other people creatively for a long time, I'm re-emerging into that kind of sort of selfish panic, in a way, I think is the best way to call it. So Studio OK, just giving you a quick rundown of some of the things I've done there. My first sort of piece there was with a whole campaign we did for Orange back in the late 90s, featuring first of all this character Larry Sticklegs, and again you notice my sort of slight shift towards more cartoon and characterful work. And then we have up here images from the other spots. We had a bunch of other directors in the studio who collectively worked on these. We got work from Mark and who else can I see up there? Mark. And I seem to have put no one else's but Mark's up there. Never mind, moving on. And I started to experiment with things other than puppets, things other than stop motion. I mentioned in my talk that I did some work up in the States for Colossal Pictures and started to work on a couple of big Hollywood movies. One of them was Mars Attacks. I pride myself on being probably the last person to have been hired on Mars Attacks by the animation director. I must have jinxed the whole thing because a week later all of us were fired. And the movie went from being made traditionally in stop motion animation, which is what Tim Burton, the director, wanted, to being made in computer animation. So on the plane home, I thought to myself, well, I really should investigate the possibilities of working with computers, because if I don't, I'm not going to be working outside of cheap children's television ever again. So we started messing around with things like this. This is a commercial we did for Time magazine. It's a very simple premise. I always think of it as slightly sort of schoolboy politics, but it's a cruise missile turning into, or rather an oil well turning into a cruise missile. That was the brief. It was a single line on for a script. We had 20 seconds, and it looks like this. Can we just switch the light off while on the front of the camera while the, thank you. So that's playing with, you know, a couple of things. Playing with the sort of the security camera or the drone's eye view you get on a missile, and also trying to find ways of introducing texture into 3D. It's a kind of contradiction in terms, because you're working with pixels and you start talking about pattern and texture and substance. But there's I think there's sometimes with computers, there's a human need to take things away from images which are very stark and harsh. It's actually interesting, since the time when we did work like this, we've started to work with pieces which are much more brutal and simple, and I'm going to show you some more of that in a minute. I made a big play about this at the weekend. This, I call a career low, even though it was actually a very, very interesting job to work on, but it was a washing machine commercial, so come on. Very good washing machine, and as I've bored everyone about this for the last 6 years, I'm going to bore you about it now. I can answer any question you like on washing machines and how they function, because I had the pleasure of having been instructed by James Dyson himself into why your washing machine doesn't work and why his does. And I went to I spent a lot of time staring into washing machines with him. But at that point, I realized this is not why I went to art college. This is not why I wore a beret.